Neighborhood Health Watch is sponsored by the doctors of HCA Virginia Health System.
Today in Neighborhood Health Watch, we're discussing gastroparesis, a condition in which the spontaneous movement of the muscles in your stomach does not function normally. Ordinarily, a person's muscles contract and are strong enough to push the food along through your digestive tract. But gastroparesis impacts the muscles and causes them to work poorly or not at all, and this can prevent your stomach from emptying properly. Dr. Matthew Brengman with Parham Doctors Hospital and Advanced Surgical Partners of Virginia is here to talk about it. What is life like for someone with this?
Well, for somebody who has symptoms from the disease, and a minority of people have symptoms, it can be pretty distressing, from bloating and nausea to pain when they eat. In severe cases, that can lead to vomiting or even unintentional weight loss. And those are the people we tend to see for therapy.
Who's most at risk for gastroparesis?
Well, it comes in sort of two groups. There's people who have longer term diabetes, so type 1 diabetes for 20 years or so. Mm-hmm. And then middle-aged women seem to be a population that's at higher risk.
And what are your treatment options? If there is no cure, how do you treat it?
Well, by far the first and most important thing is dietary therapy. To see a dietitian who has some experience with the disease that can make the recommendations around what you're eating. Then there's some drug therapy, although there's important side effects that people need to be wary of. Mm-hmm. And then for a small percentage where those things don't work, we do surgical therapy.
Mm-hmm. And what's the outlook for someone who seeks medical attention? What's the prognosis?
You know, almost always for somebody who has the disease, we can affect therapy that's going to improve their lifestyle. So whether it's mm-hmm. dietary, medical, or therapy, there's an answer for almost all patients.
Mm-hmm. And how should a person prepare for the doctors? I mean, if you have some of these symptoms, how do you know that this is specifically this condition?
It's most important, if you're going to see a specialist for the disease, to bring your records with you. Most mm-hmm. people have had the symptoms for many years and have had many interventions. Endoscopies, even sometimes having their gallbladder removed to try to treat the therapy. Mm-hmm. So when I see patients for this disease, mostly it's having the records available so that we can do some diagnosis and then plan the therapy.
And it's still not clear what causes it though, right?
Yeah, we really don't know. So the diabetics, we think it's a form of neuropathy. And for the non-diabetics, we think it may be a post-viral syndrome where people have a bad gastrointestinal illness and then the intestines just never recover.
All right, Dr. Brengman, thank you so much for getting us informed.
Thank you so much for having me.